In order to automate with VB.NET in SAP, you need to insert the DLLs to UiPath. You can do this as follows. Navigate to Manage Packages. And then navigate to All Packages. Write in the search box, SAP GUI. Install the package. After installing, you can use these DLLs in your code to automate SAP with VB.NET or also with C#. Now I will write the code to connect with SAP application. Add activity, invoke code. Make sure that the programming language is VB.NET. At the beginning, we need to connect to the SAP application and get the connection and session. These can we do with this part of code. Now we are connected with SAP and we can define the elements of SAP to automate our process. Before we continue with the code, I will show you how to define the individual items in SAP. We will see what the statement looks like and what parts does a statement consist of. To define each element in SAP, we need the following statement, which consists of 5 parts. This statement below is just an example to define the main window. The first part is, dim to define a variable and the name of this variable. The second part is, SA foos from the DLL, and then the type of the SAP element, for example, GUI main window. The second part and the fifth part are the same always. The third part is C type and then, the session variable from the code with function find by ID. The fourth part is the ID of the SAP element, like window 0. I will now introduce you the parts in detail. First part, name for the element. You can choose the name by yourself. It is better to always take the type of the element at the beginning, then the name of the element, for example main window, text currency, or button process open items. The second and fifth part are the same. It is the element type, that means we choose for example, GUI text field for a text field, or GUI button for a button, or GUI radio button for a radio button. The third part consists of 3 parts. C type at the beginning, SAP session variable which we defined in the code, and the function find by ID to select the element with its ID. The fourth part is the ID of the element in SAP. For example, Window 0, or Window 0 Toolbar 1 Button 17. Now we know what a statement consists of and can continue writing the code. In this part of video, I will show you how to call up transaction F39, and then fill in various fields, and at the end read out the status text. Thank you. Now I'm going to write the code to fill in these fields in SAP and output the status text in UiPath. Now I will run the code to see how it works. You can see how fast the bot is. It is done. I will see the output in the output console in UiPath. This text is from SAP from the status pane. I will show you this text in SAP. You can also see how the fields are filled in SAP, as we entered it in the code. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please don't forget to like and comment. See you in the next video.